Hello and welcome to the demonstration of APSI Connect. In today's demonstration, we will be showcasing you the integration between HubSpot and SAP B1 by using our product APSI Connect. So I already have created a connector between HubSpot and SAP B1 in my organization. So if I open the organization, then you can find the connector between HubSpot and B1 is created. Now I have a demo HubSpot CRM account which is connected with the demo database company of ACP, and I am starting off with the customer, or I can say the company sync. On that case, I will create a new company here. Also, I will assign a contact person under that particular company, and I will sync that from HubSpot to ACP direction. So let's add the company domain first and all the mandatory field like the name, industry, all the details I'm putting here. Here I can choose all the information, and once it is done, let's just create this company. Once the company has been added, I will quickly go to the contacts tab where I can create a new contact person. So let's add first an unique email ID for the contact person and all the mandatory information, like I'm putting the first and last name, and let's put a phone number. So I have added all the mandatory fields. Now click on this create account. Now I have assigned that contact person in the company, as you can see. Now I'm quickly go to the agent. Our APSI Connect agent, if I logged in with the same credential which I've used for the portal, so all configuration which I have done in the portal, those will be reflecting. So in the sync panel, you can find the integration point. I already have validated HubSpot CRM and ACP B1 by putting the information regarding its credential. And once the validation has been done, I will go to the sync panel where I can find all the integration point. As you can see, I have set the integration point in auto mode, so you can set the time. So here I have put the time in 2 minutes. So every 2 minutes, data will synchronize automatically. I don't have to trigger anything. Once the synchronization has been done, you can find the result in the resync bucket. Now, once the synchronization has been done, you can find the result in this resync bucket. So here is the resync bucket where you can get to know about the result, like whether it is successfully synced or not, or if any kind of failure occurred, you can get the failure messages or details regarding the synchronization. For example, you are adding a company or contact person and you forgot to add a mandatory field, suppose the mail ID. So on that case, you can find those information over here. You also can track the synchronization. We have two options. One is the resync bucket, as I already have showcased, and this is the error log where I can track the synchronization according to the timestamp. Now I will quickly go to the SAP, and under business partner master data, let's find with the name which I have created newly. So I'm finding with the company name. So here you can see the exact company which I have created under HubSpot CRM, and those details which I have provided, those are showing, like the phone number, email and other information. If I go to the contact person tab, so the contact person which I have assigned with this company, those informations are showing. Also in the addresses page, the address details which I have added for the company, those are also visible here. And in the UDF section, you can find the exact web ID, like this is the exact company ID you can have in your ACP side. Now moving to the next integration, that will be deal or opportunity ad. For that, I'm going to the opportunity ad or deal ad section. So here under the sales, you can find the deals where I can create a new deal here in the CRM side, like in the HubSpot side. So let's add a deal name. After that, let's put all the information. So here I have to mention the price, of course, and of course our close date. And you can search the company. Let's find here the company and let's add the contact person. here is the contact person. Now I'm adding a deal over here. So once it is created, I will go back to the agent to start or to check the result. So it is in already in auto mode, so I can check the result in the recent bucket. So you can find the result of the synchronization. Now I'm quickly go to the opportunities tab, and under the opportunity, let's find with the details, like this is the opportunity number and CRM ID is also you can find here. So this is the exact opportunity or deal at. So you can find the deal under the opportunity section in SAP, and all the details which I have added, those are showing here, like the potential amount, the stages, on informations are visible. So you can find the stages also, and in the exact ID, like deal ID, you can have in your SAP UDF section by using this. So these are the integration points which I have configured for this HubSpot CRM and SAP integration purpose. If you have any kind of queries, you can contact AppSeekConnect team. Thank you.